ability to be able to do that. Thank you, Bob, very, very much. You guys thank him for that, would you please? Look at their joy. Look at that. Look at the joy that's in their faces. And as they walk around, they celebrate each other. How many hours do you suppose it took for them to get that, to carry off that whole mission and to be able to make that happen? And how many man hours were put into that? And how many dollars were spent in order to do that? Guess where that money came from? From you and me. And I don't fault that at all. I think it's wonderful. I think it's incredible that we use the gifts and the ability that God has given to us to be able to reach out into outer space. Because every time we go a little bit further out, it just shows me again and shows you again the vastness of God and the power of God and the incredibleness of this universe, right? I can imagine, I wish I could have got a picture of what the earth looks like from there, right? This little speck that's kind of out there. And yet, why is it that we're always searching to try to find a higher power? Why is it that we're always trying to go out there to try to find what's out there and try to discover some more? And every time we go out there, we find pretty much the same kind of thing. And Christmas is all about the fact that we couldn't get to God, and we don't have to go out and try to get to God. We can't get there, but that God came down to us. John puts it this way in his gospel. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. Now that tells us that Jesus has been around since the beginning of time and before the beginning of time. That Jesus didn't just come about when he was born to Mary and Joseph, but that Jesus has been around since eternity. In the beginning was the Word. And as we're searching for God, as we're going out and looking for God and going out and trying to find him, we're not going to find him there. And in fact, God has come down to us. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And then it says later on, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. See, that's the beauty. That's the beauty of Christmas, is that God has come down to us. And Jesus has come down to us. And Jesus became a human being. He is still a human being. He is still fully God. He is there for us in heaven. When he ascended back into heaven, he didn't leave that human part of him behind. No, that same Savior who came as a baby in Bethlehem is that same Savior who is in heaven, who as being 100% human can relate with our situation, knows what it's like, but yet is still God. And it's still that transcendent God who created the world, who made it all. In fact, John even says that Jesus was around at creation, that Jesus was there in creation, a part of that created order that God made. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And with all of our technology and with all the money that we can spend it and with all the advances we've made over the years, oh my gosh, incredible. Incredible in all of that. When God chooses to come down to the world, he comes as a baby in a manger for us. He comes to common people like Mary and Joseph. And the first who get to hear the message are the shepherds who are out doing their job, the common laborers out there doing their job. And he comes. And that's the beauty of Christmas, isn't it? That instead of us trying to get to God, which we can't do, we can't reach him there. Instead of us trying to get to him, God comes down to us. And with all of our fascination of what's out there in outer space and out there beyond what we can see and what we experience here in this earth, God comes down to us. And he knows what our life is like. And in his son, he lives, he dies, he rises again, and he gives us life. But think about this. Why did God become human being except that? Well, step back for a moment. Unfortunately, in my lifetime too, and for many of you as well, we've seen some failures when it comes to the space program, right? We've seen two shuttles get blown up, right? We've seen people die. We've experienced that. Where does that come from? Why does that happen? Well, because we live in a sinful world, and we've fallen short of the glory of God. And that sin has wrecked God's perfect created order, and because of that, there's things like death. And into that world, God sends his son, Jesus Christ, born of a woman, born under the law, the Bible tells us, that he might redeem and buy back all of those who are also under that same law too. So while we're out reaching and going out further and further, and we're able to see even further and further out into space, and we go out even further and further, we still haven't solved that problem of death. And we still haven't solved that problem of sin in our life that wreaks its havoc in our lives, destroys marriages sometimes, tears apart families, brings societies and communities apart, even sometimes splits the church up. And so what do we need? We don't need another scientist. We don't need another mastermind. We need a Savior. We need a Savior who deals with the core problem that every single one of us deals with, and that's with sin. And that's exactly what we get. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And in his life and his death and his resurrection, he redeems us. Oh, it's fascinating. I love to watch. I love the mission to Mars. I love to see the photographs. I love to see all of that there. But this is about a mission too, about God's mission to us in his Son, Jesus Christ. And just as I love to tell people about and be able to watch that video and find out a little bit more, let's make sure we're people too who love to tell the greatest news of all. Not about our mission to God, but about God's mission come down to us in Jesus Christ. Blessed Christmas, Merry Christmas, great gift that God gave to us. Let's tell it in Jesus' name. Amen.